Welcome to Right Click Education, friends. So today we will discuss about the Anglo Material badge, and for that first we will open the Anglo Material official website. Okay, so click on Anglo Material. So we will open this Anglo Material website, which is material.anglo.io. Inside this we have this component CDK guide, if you see on the top navbar. So click on this component. Inside component we have a lot of elements. Today we will learn how we can implement badge in our application. So we will click on badge. If you see, we have this overview, API, an example. So first we will go to this API section. And in this API tab, we need to copy this import, which is mat badge module. Copy it and go to your VS Code. Go to app.module.ts. Here we need to paste the import of that badge modules. Then click this module, copy it, and paste in this import section where all the dependencies has been imported. Okay, now as dependency we have implemented, now we will write the HTML for it and we will see how this can be implemented and rendered on the UI. Okay, so for that, go to this Material website and then go on overview. First we should know what is this badge. Okay, so badge is a material, Angular material element, which is used with the block level element. So suppose what are the block level elements? Block level elements are span, p tags. So these are the block level elements, right? So these batches are used to show, suppose I will give you example. So whenever you want a particular notification, right? So in your app there is one notification button, and on the top of that notification button you will see the numbers, right? So you have the idea how many notification we have get. So in similar way batch work. So batch is used to implement those notification things. So if you see, right, we have this button, and on top of that this is 8. So 8 is telling that this action button has this number, that is 8. So if you have, suppose this notification button, then you will know that okay, there is 8 notification that we have got, right? Now we will see what are the different kinds of batch implementations are there. Okay, so first of all we will implement the batch. Okay, so for that, suppose this is batch, click on here to view code. Okay, and it will load HTML for you. Okay, so if you see here in the right bar, right, these are the contents of the batch. So we will know what are the batch position, batch sizing, batch visibility, theming, accessibility, all of these. And we will implement it so that you can see on the screen how it's working. Okay, so first of all we will go to batch position. Okay, so we will copy this code, we will paste it in our VS Code. But before that, if I want to read this one, by default the batch will be placed ever after the direction can be changed by defining the attribute mat batch position followed by above, below, below, before and after. Okay, let's implement it, you will get the idea. So I will paste it, and in order to see trend on the screen, I will type in this to run the application. As application runs, I will let you know. So if you see, this is batch, so this is the batch number. So on top of the button there will be a number which will say 8, and if you want to show that number in a particular position, you can manage by using this property, that is mat batch position. So if you want it before, it will here in the before you need to write before, then if you want it after, then you can write here after, top bottom, as you want to do it you can do it. Okay, so let's see how this appears on the screen. I will go to the Chrome, open localhost 4200. Okay, so if you see, this action button has a pop-up that is 8, and it is before position, right? And if you see, the action button is not looking like any material button. For that, what we will do, we will go to this button, we will import this button here and go to app.model.ts, paste it, and also in the import section paste this mat button model. Okay, so now let me again go to this localhost. If you see, right, action button before is 8. If I want to change this position, okay, so let's implement that also. Go to the HTML. So I want to position it after. Okay, so I will type here after, and if you see, the positioning has been changed, right? So in this way we can implement the batch positioning. Okay, now second thing is batch size. So basically batch are of different size, so it has three size. So the size is small, medium and large. Okay, so in order to manage the size, we can use the property binding, that is mat batch size, and you can use large or small in order to show like what size you want. So let's also implement it so that you will have a better idea. Now I will give this keyboard, that is mat batch size. Okay, let's bind this property. Okay, so suppose I give it is a large. Okay, now let's see how it works. So if you see here, this number that is showing here, it is, it has enlarged, right? So you can see the larger version of it. If I make it as a small, so in the VS Code we will make changes as small. Now if you see, it's a small here, right? And if I put it medium, okay, now you see it's like medium. So basically if you see, medium is looking good, right? So in general case we can use it. Now by default the batch is set to medium. So as I said, medium is looking bit balanced, so batch is medium by default. Now we can also see the theming of batch. Theming means what color do we want to see on the batch. Okay, so in order to change or manage the theming, we can have this matte batch color property, and we can bind with warn, primary, or ascent, whatever color we want. So let's change this also so that we can see. So if you see, we have already here matte badge color ascent, so we will change it to warn. Okay, now we will go to our UI and see how it looks. Okay, so if you see here, right, the color of this badge has been changed to red. Let's also make one more change. Let's do it primary. So it will then make the color of that badge as primary, right, if you see it. So in this way we can implement the different functionality of badge, and we can manage all the changes that we should do in badge. Okay, so that's it for this video. If you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe it for getting the latest update. Thanks for watching.